Hello, West Carrollton High School. I am Jody Morris, and I am going to present to you a virtual honors assembly. I usually run this at the end of each year, but obviously we didn't have one, so I wanted to create something to congratulate all the students that have won awards and been recognized. First, I want to say congratulations to the class of 2020. I'm so excited for you. Bummed it ended the way it did, but you should still be very proud of your accomplishments. I know I am, and all your teachers and administrators and everyone that works at the high school is so super proud of you. So don't be down. The awards, though, are not just for seniors. We do recognize seniors in a lot of their accomplishments, but there are awards for underclassmen. There are sports awards. There are music awards. There are club awards. There are special videos. Lots of things for you to enjoy. A lot of the teachers, administrators, secretaries have done a lot of work, counselors, to put together these videos. So I hope you enjoy them. And we just want to congratulate everyone for a great ending to a good year. And hopefully we see you all next year. Enjoy.
We're going to miss you, Ms. Greisinger. You're the best. You really know how to mix things up.
Miss G, you are so amazing.
We hope you never change. We love you.
Thank you for all you've done for West Carrollton High School. We're going to miss you, Miss G.
I just wanted to take a brief minute to wish Rebecca Hayden a congratulations on retirement. You will be deeply missed in our classroom. It'll be weird going from our classroom back to my classroom. You were a great partner, somebody that was great to work with, and will be very, very, very hard to replace. I don't usually give up the reins a lot in my room, and I could trust Rebecca whenever I needed, and that we really did have a partnership instead of your kids versus my kids. Again, congratulations on retirement, and I will miss you a lot.
Happy birthday, Miss Aiden. I love you and miss you so much. I hope we can see you soon, and I hope you're doing really well. Be safe, and have a great day.
Hi, Miss Aiden. I hope you're okay. I know today is a really special day for you because it's your birthday. I just want to tell you happy birthday, Miss Aiden. I hope you enjoy your day. I really miss you, Miss Aiden. Love you. Bye.
Happy birthday, Miss Aiden. Thank you for everything that you do for me. Sorry for everything that I do wrong for you. Enjoy your day. I know you're in quarantine right now, but enjoy. I love you, Miss Aiden.
Miss Aiden, I'm working right now, but I remember that you celebrated your birthday. So happy birthday, and I hope you're enjoying your day. I don't think so, but I hope. And yeah, I miss you.
We need a picture of
everybody.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday, Miss Aiden, and I just want to thank you for everything you have done for me last year to graduate. And happy birthday, and I wish you the best of luck and good luck in your life. Thank you.
Happy birthday! Joyeux anniversaire, Mrs. Hayden. I wish you all the best. Je te souhaite tout le bonheur du monde, santé, prospérité, amour. May Allah bless you and give you long life. I hope you enjoy it. I love you so much and I miss you so much. Enjoy, Miss Hayden.
Mwah. Feliz cumpleaños, Miss Hayden. I miss you.
Hi, Miss Hayden. It's Paulette. On behalf of me and Paula, we just want to wish you happy birthday. You're 1 year older, you're wiser, you're loving. I just want to wish you more blessings, love, happiness, joy. Have a wonderful birthday, Miss Hayden. I miss you so much. God bless you, and I love you.
Hey, Mrs. Hayden, happy birthday. I love you, and I miss you.
Hello, Pirates. Each year, a student is selected who has made a significant change over the 4 years that they have been with us.
This change could be in the areas of academics, behavior, attitude, or all of the above. The student that we have chosen for our turnaround award has never really had significant behavior issues. He's managed to pass most of his classes, and he's generally pleasant. However, he just didn't live up to his potential until this year. A stranger to our school and to this student had this to say: I was one of the officials assigned to the boys varsity contest on Piqua versus Piqua on Saturday night at Butler High School. I know that when you receive emails from officials, it's not normally good news. However, this is not the case. I want to acknowledge a player that really caught my attention, player number 2. I do not know his name. However, he was a true leader, a true competitor, and one of the most respectful young men I have had the pleasure of officiating this season. We all know number 2 as Zaire Hopkins Martinez. Zaire has demonstrated a maturity and drive this year that has really made him stand out. We are very proud that this year he lived up to that potential that we all knew that he had. Congratulations, Zaire, for receiving the Turnaround Award for the Class of 2020. We are very proud of you.
Hi, everybody. It's Ms. Bukowski.
Hi, it's Mrs. Longo.
And we're the band directors at the high school, and we are here today to present the Semper Fidelis Award for Musical Excellence. And this award goes out to 2 seniors that it's designed to recognize distinguished high school band members for musical achievements and leadership as a high school scholar. The candidate should be exemplary young citizens and role models for other students. And this program is sponsored by the United States Marine Youth Foundation. The requirements of this award are: you have to be a high school senior, you have to hold a first chair position in band, you have to be capable of performing as a soloist with a high school band, and be recognized as both an outstanding performer and a truly outstanding young citizen.
This year, our recipients are Megan and Hannah Berkey. Congratulations.
Hi, my name is Olivia, and I am going to be announcing the athletic awards. Starting off with the Freshman Male Athlete AC Isley Award goes to Logan Cloyd. The Freshman Female Athlete Jan Barker Award goes to Ashaya Sales. Next, the Sophomore Male Pirate of the Year goes to Cole McCandless. The Sophomore Female Pirate of the Year goes to Allie Parker. Next, the Junior Male Pirate of the Year goes to Devon Lander. The Female Junior Pirate of the Year goes to Lexi Varro. Next, the Senior Male Pirate of the Year Award goes to Austin Bauer-Jones and Kaylin McKinney. The Senior Female Pirate of the Year Award goes to Gabriela Arano. The Male OHSAA Scholar Athlete Award goes to Sean Garvey. And last but not least, the Female OHSAA Scholar Athlete Award goes to Megan Berkey. Congratulations, everyone.
Hi, this is Mrs. Morris. I am presenting the Miami Valley CTC Principals Award. Let me give you a little description of it. This coincides with a certificate of recognition with honors. To be eligible, a student has to have a 3.25 GPA for at least 3 semesters, and then they have to have a 97% attendance, which means they can only miss 11 or fewer days the entire year. The students are initially eligible through that criteria, and then teachers and staff choose the actual award recipients. So congratulations to the 2020 Miami Valley CTC Principals Award, and let me read the names. Hopefully I pronounce them correctly. Colin Baker, Emma Becker, Taylor Ferguson, Cameron Gamble, Taylor McDonald, Kiana McGrath, Atlee McNett, Trinity Minge, Nolan Pack, and Jade Yang. Congratulations.
Hello. Merle Huffman's passion and calling in life was teaching in public schools. This scholarship was established in celebration of his 100th birthday by his family, friends, colleagues, and the many students Merle taught in his 37 years as a social studies teacher at West Carrollton High School, and 22 more years as a substitute teacher. Merle is credited with starting our student-led graduation tradition over 50 years ago, a tradition that continues to this day. Merle's energy and spirit for seeing the value and potential of all students and for challenging each to be a participant in his or her own life, community, country, and universe is the impetus for this award. This scholarship will be awarded to a graduating West Carrollton High School student who shows strong creative and risk-taking abilities, qualities that Merle's friend Charles F. Kettering advised him were the most important to cultivate in his students. Applicants for this scholarship must be a graduating senior from West Carrollton High School or a West Carrollton High School student that attended Miami Valley Career Technology Center. Applicants must demonstrate innovative and original thinking and or purpose, demonstrate quality, character, and originality, be accepted to an accredited 2 or 4 year college, university, or trade school as a full-time student. It is my privilege today to present this scholarship to Mr. Sean Garvey. He will be attending The Ohio State University in the fall and majoring in social studies education. Sean, congratulations to you and best of luck.
Hello. My name is Michael Scott, and I'm presenting the Math Award for West Carrollton High School for the 2019-2020 school year. The recipient of this award, besides being very busy in extracurricular activities, maintained an A average throughout the year in calculus. This student was very motivated, hardworking, intelligent, and intuitive mathematically. I enjoyed teaching the student very much throughout the year, and I am honored to present the West Carrollton High School Math Award for the 2019-2020 school year to Megan Bertke. Congratulations, Megan.
I'd like to take a moment to congratulate Mr. Layton Schroyer, this year's most outstanding science student. We really appreciate your dedication and hard work over the last few years, Layton. As a token of our appreciation, we'd like to present you with $100. Take care, man.
Hello. On behalf of the Social Studies Department, I am honored to present our Outstanding Social Studies Student Award today. In selecting someone for this award, we look at the following criteria: number of social studies classes taken, and the level of coursework involved, grades earned in those classes, and a devotion to pursuing a career in the social sciences. Each department member gets one vote, and in true democratic fashion, majority rules. Each student is required to earn 4 social studies classes or credits to graduate. Top finalists for this year's award earned well over the minimum social studies credits, had excellent grades, and were elected to student council. What set our recipient apart from other nominees was her participation in We the People. Personally, I had the privilege of teaching this student in 2 different social studies classes, including We the People and The Court and You. We the People requires an immense devotion of time both in and outside of the classroom. Students participate in a state constitutional competition, testifying before a panel of judges. I met Olivia Davis as a sophomore. She worked tirelessly with her group members to help earn a 3rd place trophy for the West Carrollton We the People team. Her senior year, I had the privilege of teaching her in The Court and You. And the highlight of our class this year was our Innocence Project guest speaker and our field trip to the courthouse. In class this year, we conducted a moot court on the Supreme Court case Kaler versus Kansas. And Olivia was a lead attorney. Using her skills obtained at We the People, she presented her side of the case to our student panel of justices. This spring, Olivia was awarded a Montgomery County Distinguished Young Woman Scholarship Award, and she and I were invited and attended a League of Women Voters dinner at the Dayton Art Institute. This fall, Olivia plans on attending the University of Cincinnati and majoring in criminal justice with a minor in Arabic language and culture, pursuing a certificate in war, peace, and security. Olivia, I'm proud of you. Thank you for the countless memories and the privilege of watching you grow into a responsible, respectful young woman that cares about our community and world. Thank you for being a leader both in and out of the classroom. Our Social Studies Department wishes you the best of luck. Thank you very much and congratulations.
Hola, buenos dias. Primero, yo quiero decirles a todos los seniors, mis seniors, que estoy muy triste de no poder verlos. y para decirles adiós y que los voy a extrañar y los quiero mucho. So now let's switch to the English portion. I am going to present the Spanish Beast Award. This is for a senior who has completed 5 years of Spanish and gotten A's throughout. The recipient this year is Ethan Glasgow. Woo! Efren. So Ethan is somebody who I would say he's had a hard time in some ways dealing with the free-flowing way I run class, but he stuck it out for 3 years and learned to adapt, and I'm proud of him for that. He's also somebody who has been off the charts in participation points, but if any of you know Ethan, which you might not because he's not the most talkative kind of guy, you know that participation is not something he really, you would think that he does, but he does in Spanish. And part of that is because he's somebody who knows a little bit about Latin American history, immigration, politics, science. He knows about everything. He's somebody who has a very inquisitive mind and wants to learn. And I've learned from him. You know, he did a report this year on Che Guevara, and I now know more than I ever knew about Che. And you know, if you mention some random remote island off the coast of Venezuela, Ethan's your guy. He will know about it. So I think that's kind of cool that he's has such an inquisitive mind. So Ethan, congratulations. I appreciate all the hard work. I appreciate how helpful you have always been to other people in the class, and that you've tolerated my sort of crazy way of teaching for these last 3 years. Okay. Bueno, buena suerte en el futuro. Adiós. Gracias por escuchar.
Das Herz in der Hand, der Wind im Gesicht, ein Feuer, das nie erlischt. Die Trumpf ist im Blick, es gibt kein Zurück, spürst du es wie ich?
Hey guys. Sorry, best intro I could find. I love this song that I just played. It is called O Novata by Beatrice Egli. And it's a song we learned in class, and many of my students love it because it is the English translation is without words, and it's all about working hard, working your whole life for one moment. And you guys are having your moment right now. I'm sorry that you're having it at home and that you can't have the proper celebration. Hopefully that will come soon. But anyway, this is, I hope you know, I'm Frau Ingram, Mrs. Ingram. I teach German, all levels. And my award today is the German Meisterschüler Award, which means a master scholar of the language. The two people that I nominated are Leighton Schroyer, your valedictorian, easy for me to say, and Annalise Friedlander, who you might also know as Annalise Blevins. Her name just changed recently, which is awesome because now she has a super duper German name. I don't have too much to say. You worked for this moment. Leighton, you have worked so hard. I've seen you grow and grow in confidence, grow in size. You've gotten a lot taller. Your knowledge of German is very, very good. You just are so determined to learn the language and learn about the culture. I love that you have come from kind of a shy young man to being able to open up and actually dance to our songs in German. I love when you get up and dance and when the whole class gets up, because you know I'm all about it. Annalise, I cannot say enough about, well, really either of you, sorry. I was just going through Annalise's project with her final project for German 5 CCP. And I was amazed. We were in a Google Meet meeting. She was sharing her desktop, and we were looking at her storyboard, that project, a graphic novel. We were just kind of cleaning up some grammar, and anything I said to her, like, oh no, it's, sie hatte gefragt, wer der Geist ist, or wo die Hexe ist, or whatever we were saying. I didn't have to help her with spelling. I didn't have to help with capitalization. I just read it and said, oh, you know, you could change that to this. And she just did it. She typed it. Bam. It was done. She didn't need help with punctuation. She has worked tirelessly. Also, she actually skipped a level. So did Leighton. They both did. They skipped German 3. They went straight from German 2 to German 4. And then Annalise actually is in German 5. I think she skipped it a year early. I'm not even sure. It's hard to keep track anymore when you have all these kids for 4 or 5 years. Anyway, they are, this is the closest thing to like a fire, a symbol of representation of German, like, you know, the Olympic flame. This is the closest thing I could find to kind of symbolize their achievement. They will be receiving some other awards, hopefully, if I have the right address. Anyway, I don't mean to make this too long. I'm going to end with the chorus of the song, and I hope both of you know how much I love you and how much I miss you. Last dancing. Come on, Lee. Everything was worth it.
Das ist der Tag ohne Worte. Es ist der Wahnsinn, was hier passiert. Ein Augenblick für immer und ewig, das ganz große Glück. Jetzt und hier, das ist der Tag ohne Worte. Und alles, was war, vergessen vorbei. Dieser Moment, der für immer ohne Worte steh ich hier. Die Wolken sind weg, der Himmel ist klar, das alles nicht wahr.
Trying to figure out how to stop the music, but I guess I won't. Okay. Love you guys.
This year's recipient of Outstanding Achievement in Journalism has shown dedication to her class coursework that surpasses most of the student journalists that I work with. She is a committed student who always met her deadlines and got interviews, even when her first interview ever was with the school principal. She is a student who truly understands the value in education and has been a pleasure to have in class. Congratulations to this year's recipient, Haley Laurent.
Hello. At this time, I wish to recognize the president of the student body, Brooklyn Cass, for her leadership and service to her community, her school, and to student council. As student body president, she has played a large role in setting the tone and standards for this high school. The responsibilities and tasks are extensive and demanding. I've depended on Brooklyn to fulfill this role. She has served her peers, class, and this student body for 4 years on council. Brooklyn's fellow officers have described her as doing the most work for council this year. She made sure everything got done. She's a great leader and contributing role model to this school. She was great at leading our weekly meetings and bringing ideas to the table. Personally, I've had the pleasure of watching Brooklyn grow so much over the past 4 years. It has been a privilege to work with her both in and out of the classroom. She has been able to develop the traits of an excellent leader. This fall, Brooklyn will be attending Wright State on a full scholarship, majoring in nursing. When things return to normal, I plan on presenting Brooklyn with a gavel. The president's gavel is a symbol of leadership. Thank you, Brooklyn. I miss you. At this time, I would like to recognize the other senior student body and class officers. They are Jillian Malin, Angel Nguyen, Olivia Davis, Carmen Blizzard, Nathan Davis, Britton Lawless, and Jillian Wagner. Many students are unaware of the activities that council either directs or participates in. And along with the other underclassmen representatives, these students have given up countless mornings, lunches, and weekends to help with school and community events. Though we are not ending this year as anticipated, these students still deserve recognition for their leadership to their class and to this school. Thank you, class of 2020 leaders. Tim Przybrowski was a young man who led his class as president for 3 years at West Carrollton High School. He graduated with the class of 1985. After an extended illness, he passed away in 1987, and to honor his memory, his classmates dedicated a tree in the courtyard. The West Carrollton High School Student Council, with the help of Tim's family, has established this award in his memory to recognize an outstanding officer in each class. The recipients of each award are chosen anonymously by student council officers. This year's outstanding freshman officer is Gracie Klein. Gracie was described by her fellow officers as being eager to help, going above and beyond the expectations of a freshman, and participating in everything. Thank you, Gracie. This year's outstanding sophomore officer is Kendall Adams. Kendall was described by her peers as an officer that is organized and helps the most, an officer that is hardworking and the perfect example of a leader for her class, the only officer volunteering to get our lounge done. Thank you, Kendall. This year's outstanding junior officer is Grace Blakely. Grace was described by peers as an amazing person and a hard worker, an officer who helped organize the Don't Give Up project, and someone who is always so positive. Thank you, Gracie. This year's outstanding senior officer is Olivia Davis. Olivia has served her class on student council both her junior and senior years. Olivia, one of your peers said that you held a meeting and did your very best to organize class t-shirts. Another said Olivia is friendly and put a lot of effort into student council this year. A special thanks to all this year's senior officers for your leadership, hard work, and dedication to West Carrollton Senior High. Class of 2020, though we are not participating in the graduation we had planned, it will still be great. Thank you for the memories, congratulations, and best of luck to each of you.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it! We are all so proud of you. I would like to recognize two individual awards today. As a co-advisor with Mrs. Morris and National Honor Society, we have had a great year of service. Our NHS Community Christmas Party served over 200 kids district-wide. Collectively, NHS has provided over 2,300 hours of service throughout various activities such as tutoring, food drive collections, volunteering in medical facilities, and helping community members. This year, our first award goes to our first year member, Chase Adams. Chase Adams, please stand up. Are you standing? I think you are. NHS member Harley Blackford has said this of Chase. I saw Chase in almost every volunteering opportunity. He is so hardworking in everything he does while also juggling cross country, robotics, and swim team. Chase is such a great person who has an outstanding character. He has amazing integrity and maintains his scholarship. He truly exemplifies what it means to be an NHS member. Congratulations, Chase. You may sit down now. Our next award is for the outstanding second year NHS member. I call valedictorian to front and center, Leighton Schroyer. Leighton, congrats to your outstanding service, leadership, and scholarship. You've held many positions at West Carrollton High School, NHS treasurer, captain of the academic challenge team, just to name a few. We are so proud of your accomplishments. You stand here before your classmates and pirate family as a proud young man, and we know you will continue to grow in your education and especially in your humanitarian service to your community. It is with great pleasure and honor that I am presenting this award to you. Congrats, Leighton Schroyer, for outstanding second year National Honor Society member. To all of you graduates, continue to be resilient. Continue to keep that grit. And don't stop believing. We love you.
Hey guys, it's McGuff and Ingram here to present your 2019-2020 Drama Awards. Before we get into the Super Awards, we wanted to give some nice shout outs to a couple of our seniors. Starting off, we have the Golden Retriever Award here. So the Juergens twins, Jordan and Jesse. They were they started getting called the Golden Retrievers by the kids.
Yes.
Yeah, they were always willing to jump up and fetch whatever was needed from them. They really did about everything. Light booth, sound booth, even jumped on stage once.
Bouncers,
yep. They did our tickets. They pretty much did everything, or were very willing to do so.
Built.
Shout out. Our second one. Go ahead, Ingram. This is on you.
Oh, it's on me. Okay. Well, this is for Jordan Webb. She was instrumental behind the scenes in nearly every production, maybe all productions. She helped, like the Juergens twins, with building. She could wield a paintbrush. She could build a set. She could wield a makeup brush and do makeup. And she was usually there if we needed her. She also, we could count on her to show other people what they needed to do. And yeah. So we could really rely on her.
And she was really self-driven. That's the biggest thing. It's like she knew what needed to be done and she did it. We didn't have to be there to poke at her to get things done. All right.
Where's the glitter?
I don't have any glitter. Did you? You forgot the glitter.
I was supposed to get the glitter. I have, how about a balloon?
Okay. Hey! I didn't even know we had that. Look at us. Okay. So, our first drama award for this year goes to a lovely young lady who was with us since her freshman year. Due to some extenuating circumstances, wasn't on stage with us this year. She's been around for, she was with us every single year. Always had her lines down early. But the Speed Racer Award goes to Bree White.
And where's our Speed Racer? There it is.
And Bree's thing, we always would try to make her slow down. But she never would. So she got her lines down so quickly that she would always speed through them. And that girl can fast talk like anybody.
She won the speed throughs.
Yeah, one of our favorite things is that we would make her slow down and go at a snail's pace. But it was a torture and it was fun to watch. But she did always master through when we did speed throughs. So she did have that.
She did?
Yeah. All right, our other award.
Oh my gosh. What to do? Okay.
Are you ready? Okay. wait. This also lovely young lady has grown in a lot of ways. You know, it's very obvious for us to look back and see that her art and everything about her has just, you know, she continues to grow and become a better person and find her light, as you will. Yes, the Sunflower Award goes to Cece Race. Yes. So she always found her light, like we said, which means more than one thing. On stage, we would always yell, find your light. We even played a game one year. Do you remember this game?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we would take the light and just flash it on in different places and make them find it. Yeah, it was hilarious. But her personality... Yeah. What has happened there? Her personality is like the sun, you know, like she's bright, she's beautiful, and she always, always was able to bring joy to those around her. So again, we love all of you drama geeks and drama kids. We miss you all so much. Hope to see you soon and have a great day. Bye.
So the next award that I'm going to present is the Orion Award. Orion was a Greek musician, and he was one of the first musicians to be recognized and honored really across the entire world, which at the time was the Greek Empire. And he was thrown from a ship out of jealousy of the crew members for all of the riches that he had received from his performances. But he was rescued by dolphins and brought back to land, is the legend as it goes. So Orion Award is given for outstanding contributions to a choral program and for performing ability. And that normally goes to one of our juniors, and this year is no different. That award is going to Kyra West. That award is on back order because of shipping issues from the company it was coming from. So we will have it in the fall, but I don't have it to show you right now. It's got a medallion that the student can wear, and then it also has a desk plaque that goes with it. The next award that we're giving out is another award I don't have with me tonight, and that's the Glenn Slattery Leadership Award. Glenn Slattery was the president of our Vocal Boosters many years ago, and he died tragically in a car accident the week before our musical opened. And his family and our program has always honored one of our senior leaders with that leadership award in his name. And here's that award. And Sarah is one of those quiet leaders because she's always showing by example and helping students out in her section, and has been a fantastic leader in our program. So congratulations, Sarah. Leadership Award. The next award is the National High School Choral Award, and that award also goes to one of our seniors. That award is one of the highest achievements and highest recognitions that we give to students. It's a national award, like the Orion Award, and it's again given for dedication and outstanding achievement and contributions to a school choral program. And here's the presentation for that award. And this year, the National High School Choral Award goes to Brittany Iser.
Woo! Perfect. Woo!
That's the only thing that's not in the Saturday. It's a little, you know, the final senior award that we give out is the award for Vicky's Reflection. Vicky Hook was a student at the high school in 1981, the class of 81, and she tragically died a few weeks before her graduation. We've always honored a student with Vicky's Reflection. That award is one selected by the students, and that award recognizes a student who gives outstanding contributions to the program, not necessarily in their performances, but in their encouragement and support of the program, supporting all of our students regardless of what choir they're in, supporting our program, and just being an all-around outstanding student and a great friend to all of our choir members. And here's the presentation of that award. So for the 2020 Vicky's Reflection goes to Jordan Jurgens.
Woo! Sound effects! Woo! All right.
Oh, When the sun goes down, we raise your cup. Oh, oh, oh,
I wish that I could witness all your joy and all your pain. But until my moment comes, I'll say,
today to celebrate our Pirates who achieved perfect attendance for the 2019-2020 school year. So congratulations to the following students. Forgive me as I look down and I read my lists, but here we go. Heidi Anderson, Aiden Beal, Sean Beigel, Hannah Burkey, Megan Burkey, Harley Blackford, Adam Blair, Desiree Blessed, Colton Burchette, Hui Chen, Noah Clark, Riley Dean, Lucas Eisel, Taylor Ferguson, Zachary Foreman, Oscar Garcia Pineda, Rachel Herferth, Vichika Hoy, Jacob Hudepol, Tyler Knott, Tamer Laffey, Kieran Marshall, Amaya Martin, Mamadou Ngam, Jalen Norris, Yanushka Nunez Rivera, Nolan Peck, Michaela Penson, Jonathan Perkins, Rebecca Rutherford, Kylie Rost, Mauricio Salas, Jarrell Sanders, Zachary Schober, Kira Short, Lori Sutter, Andrew Tran, Hunter Van Ostall, Gabriel Vanderpool, Nathan Wagner, Ashley Williams, Leanna Yancey, Jade Yang, and Aisha Ziyadi. So congratulations, Pirates, on your perfect attendance achievement. We miss you all. We really do. This school is not the same without our Pirates there and the energy you bring to it. So we just want you to know that we truly miss you. To the class of 2020, congratulations. And just know that we are celebrating you and we are proud of you. I miss you guys.
Hi, this is Mrs. Morris, and I'm going to present the 2020 Buckeye Boys State Representatives and 2020 Buckeye Girls State Representatives. I will start with a little description of how they're chosen. The social studies teachers, the counselors, and the administrators select up to 7 boys and 7 girls, and then they are interviewed by the Buckeye Boys Girls Committee, and they're chosen from there. These are some of the qualifications that help them get chosen for the initial seven. They should have a good scholastic ranking and be recommended by administration, counselors, and social studies teachers. Students should possess qualities of leadership, scholarship, scholastic achievement, good citizenship, and a willingness to participate. And then they should demonstrate an interest in the United States history, government, and civics. Debate or public speaking is a benefit to all candidates. So this year's 2020 Buckeye Boys State representatives are Chase Adams, Noah Babb, Ashton Davey, Victor Callen, Keaton Kinderdine, Alec LeBlanc, and Shundrick Parker. Congratulations to all of you. The 2020 Buckeye Girls State representatives are Grace Blakely and Margot Hauser. And we do have three alternates for the girls, Sarah Daly, Layla Bohannon, and Naomi Gooseby. So congratulations to all of you.
Hi Pirates. Every year, the high school newspaper recognizes 20 seniors who have been deemed outstanding by their peers and the staff at West Carrollton High School. This year, I sent a ballot with all the seniors who have maintained a 2.5 GPA and higher to the staff and the seniors and asked them to nominate students who they believe to be outstanding. These 20 students are voted outstanding because of the way they represent West Carrollton High School inside and outside of the classroom, on the field, and among their peers. I believe this honor is especially wonderful because you, the graduating class, get to participate in recognizing your fellow seniors. So, I will read you the names of the 20 most outstanding seniors. I do want to apologize because I didn't get to practice pronouncing all your names with some of your teachers this year because we're all at home. So if I mispronounce your name, I'm so sorry, but congratulations to the 10 outstanding senior girls: Gabriella Ariano Sendejas, Carmen Blizzard, Ashlyn Bailey, Hannah Berkey, Megan Berkey, Brooklyn Cass, Olivia Davis, Casey Haw, Brittany Iser, and Jillian Wagner. Congratulations to the outstanding senior boys: Tyrin Brinner, Dorian Cooper, Nathan Davis, Sean Garvey, Jordan Jurgens, Logan Mullins, Angel Wynn, Joseph Schaefer, Leighton Schroyer, and Caleb Wilson.
Hello. It is with pride that I am able to present today's Most Outstanding Male Award. This award is quite prestigious for many reasons, and all of the top 10 male and female nominees should be commended for their hard work and dedication to academic and school pride. Today, I congratulate Mr. Caleb Wilson on being selected by his class and the West Carrollton High School staff as the Most Outstanding Male of the Class of 2020. I had the opportunity to work with Caleb in the classroom both his sophomore and junior years. As a sophomore, Caleb was committed to the We the People team, working tirelessly for both his individual unit number 5 group and his class as a whole. As a junior, he put in many extra hours of hard work in order to achieve his own personal ACT goal, an accomplishment which has opened many doors of opportunity for Caleb this past year. Caleb lettered all 4 years of high school on the track team, and he is the only student in the last 2 decades to serve as the track team captain freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior years. Caleb has been relentless in pursuing his academic and athletic achievements over the past 4 years. He has been a student leader and role model both in and out of the classroom. I am confident that Caleb Wilson has all the necessary skills to accomplish all of his future dreams and aspirations. In the fall, Caleb will attend the University of Kentucky pursuing a degree in exercise science. Caleb, it has been a pleasure working with you over the years. I wish you nothing but the best. I congratulate you, and I thank you for making a difference at West Carrollton High School. Best of luck.
Hola, I am Senora Ulrich, and I am here to present the Outstanding Senior Girl Award for this year. Our Outstanding Senior Girl this year is Casey Ha. Yay! I've had the pleasure of having Casey in class for the last 2 years in Spanish 3 and 4. She has also been a long-term member of Culture Club, which is an assembly we put on every year. And perform dances and talk about the different cultures in our school. And Casey's been a great part of that. Casey Ha is truly a Renaissance woman. She does it all. She plays
violin in the orchestra, and she's been an ensemble leader in that. She is in NHS. She plays tennis on the tennis team. She has competed at a high level in regional competitions with the Business Professionals of America. And she has completed all her community service hours, helping with the Pink Out tailgate and the community Christmas party and you name it. Casey's been in everything. She does this all while she holds down a job or maybe two jobs, not sure. And she helps out a lot with her family. She is someone who lights up a room when she comes in. She's energetic and enthusiastic about everything that she does. It's rare to have a day when Casey's not pretty fun to be around. Mrs. Earle, the Business Professionals of America leader, has described her. She said she's helped out a lot every time they help with Special Olympic events. To quote Mrs. Earle, she said she's the coolest chick out there. She said she's wonderful with all of the athletes and cheering them on, and a true team player for the Special Olympics events. In Culture Club this year, she's usually participated in dancing and speaking. And this year, for the first time, she even sang on stage and she tore it up. So she's somebody who just is truly a pleasure to be around. She does not judge people for their abilities or lack thereof, and she steps in whenever she's needed. She does all this while suffering from a fairly serious case of senioritis the last couple of years. Yes, that's right, since she was a junior. But maybe more impressive than that is that Casey does all this, well, okay, maybe not play tennis, wearing heels that are 3 to 4 inches almost every day to school. It's rather impressive. So I just want to say congratulations to Casey. I am proud to be here to represent you. You've been a wonderful representative of West Carrollton High School in so many ways and on so many platforms in these last 4 years. And whatever college gets you, Casey, we'll be lucky. Congratulations.
Hi, my name is Olivia Davis, and I will be announcing the recipients of the Honors Diploma. First, I will start off by reading out the criteria. Students that attend WCHS for 4 years must complete the college prep curriculum and must meet at least 6 out of the 7 following criteria. First, they have to earn 4 credits of math, including Algebra 1, Geometry, and Algebra 2, or the equivalent, and another higher level course. Second, they have to earn 4 credits of science, and that includes 2 units of an advanced science. 3, they have to earn 4 credits of social studies. 4, they have to earn 3 credits of 1 foreign language, or 2 units of the 2 languages. 5, they have to earn 1 credit of fine arts. 6, they must maintain a 3.5 GPA on a 4.0 scale. And lastly, number 7, they must obtain a composite score of 27 on the ACT or a 1210 on the SAT. Now I will list off the Honors Diploma recipients. Starting off with Cassie Adkins, Gabriela Arano Candejas, Ashlyn Bailey, Danielle Belleville, Hannah Berkey, Megan Berkey, Annalise Blevins, Carmen Blizzard, Riley Calico, Brooklyn Cass, Olivia Davis, Nathan Davis, Brenna Fine, Sean Garvey, Ethan Glasgow, Casey Ha, Ethan Imes, Brittany Iser, Mason Jones, Kiana McGrath, Trinity Mingi, Wassem Moreb, Angel Nguyen, Cece Race, Leighton Schroyer, Jillian Wagner, and Caleb Wilson. Congratulations, everyone.
Hi, this is Mrs. Morris. Again, hopefully you're not too tired of seeing my face. I'm going to present the President's Award for Educational Excellence. This award is intended to recognize students who have demonstrated academic success in the classroom. They must have a attendance rate of 90% or higher, a GPA of 3.5 or higher, and they must have scored at or above the 85th percentile on the SAT or ACT math or English sections. We only have four very deserving young ladies, so I'm going to read their names at this time, and I want to say congratulations. Megan Berkey, Annalise Blevins, Carmen Blizzard, and Kiana McGrath. They were the only four that met all these qualifications. So very proud of you all, and congratulations.
West Carrollton High School Counseling Department wanted to recognize the following students for obtaining a 2.5 or higher GPA and were qualified to apply for the Dayton Montgomery County Scholarship Program. These students were awarded their scholarships and they will be listed by their counselors in alphabetical order.
Hi, my name is Miss Brown. I'm the school counselor for last names A through D. I am here to recognize those students who have been awarded the Dayton Montgomery County Scholarship, and those students are Cassandra Adkins, Joelle Aparicio, Gabriela Ariano Sundahas, Paula Araguban Agbamo, Paulette Araguban Agbamo, Ashlyn Bailey, Aiden Beal, Sean Beigel, Danielle Belleville, Hannah Bertke, Megan Bertke, Annalise Blevins, now Annalise Friedlander, Carmen Blizzard, Callista Bolin, Taryn Briner, Sherilyn Calicote, Brooklyn Cass, Tristan Collins, Nathan Davis, Olivia Davis, and Tina Diang. Congratulations.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Sanders, and I have the honor of announcing the students that received the Dayton Montgomery County Scholarship with last names E through K. Those students are Milagros Espinoza Garcia, Allison Ferris, Madison Fugate, Cameron Gamble, Sean Garvey, Gwendolyn Gadeka, Ethan Glasgow, Davon Green, Adriana Harrison, Sarah Hoff, Ashton Holiday, Sophia Yicabelli, Brittany Iser, Alexandria Jaros, and Mason Jones. Congratulations, we're super proud of you guys.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Opperman, and I have the honor of announcing the scholarship recipients whose last names start with L through Q. Britton Lawless, Divine Massabiri, Kiana McGrath, Alexandra Malarick, Kiaren Marshall, Mason Mills, Danielle Mitchell, Casa Mora, Kaylee Myers, Angel Wynn, Stephen Nixon, Eli Petrie, Gracie Pige, and Tara Pryor. Congratulations.
Hi, I'm Mr. Wood, and I have the privilege of announcing the scholarship winners for students' last names R through Z. We have Courtney Schroth, Caitlin Stutz, Ashton Tilton, Jillian Wagner, and Kayla Wilson. Congrats, guys.
Congratulations, everybody. You should be proud of yourself. Keep up the hard work and take care.
Hi, everyone. My name is Olivia Davis, and I am the senior class president for the class of 2020. I want to start off by addressing the upcoming seniors. This fall, you'll be starting your senior year. You'll be the oldest ones in the school. That means that you're going to be what everybody in this district is looking up to. You're going to be the role models of not just the high school, because believe it or not, all eyes are on you right now, because this is your year. This is what you guys have been waiting for, and there are so many opportunities for you this year, and I want you to really think about that. And I encourage you to start researching your colleges and writing your essays and looking for scholarships, because once your senior year starts, it's going to go by really, really quickly, and the next thing you know, you're going to be graduating. And it's okay if you don't have everything figured out right now. No one really does, and with that being said, don't stress yourself out about college or anything else that you're doing after high school. Just take the time to have fun during your senior year, because it's really going to be one of the best years of your life. and it's going to be some of the most fun that you've ever had, and the last time that you get to see your friends and your teachers as a whole. So when you're at your last game, or your last concert, your last prom, your last pep rally, just make sure to soak it all in and have fun, because you never know when you might not get those things. I'm so excited to see what you guys become during your senior year, to see how you guys grow and mature into these adults that you're meant to be. I know many of you, and I am very close to a lot of you, and I want to wish you all good luck. And I'm so excited and happy to see what the next school year has to offer you. And I know that you guys are going to take great care of our school. And just remember, when things get tough, because senior year is very stressful at times, look around, because everybody at this school cares about you and wants to help you and wants to see you succeed. And I know that this year is going to be great. And next year, your senior class president is Zeph Sutter. I've known Zeph since middle school, and he's a really, really great person, and I know that I'm passing down the role of senior class president to the right person. If you ever have any concerns, don't be afraid to ask him, because I know that he's going to listen and he's going to do his best to make things happen for you. And also, Zeph, I know that being senior class president is a huge role to take on, but I know that you can do it, because you're a resilient person, you're smart and you're kind, and I know that you're going to be a great class president for the class of 2021. And with all of that being said, I now want to address my class, the outgoing seniors. It's been amazing to represent you guys, and I am so thankful, because you are the best class that I could ever ask for. Whenever we get together, that's some of the most fun times that I've ever had in my life, and I'm going to miss every single one of you. I've cherished my time with you guys here at West Carrollton High School, and we've had so many things that we got to offer for the school, and I'm so glad that we got the chance to. And I want you guys to remember that no matter where you're going after this, it's okay to not be certain with everything that you're doing. It's okay to be afraid. But no matter what, you still have us. If you ever need anything, you can always contact one of us, because we're a family for life. We're the class of 2020, and we're outstanding. No matter what comes in our way, nothing can ever stop us. We're always looking at what comes next, and we're always ready for it. And it's okay if you're uncertain of what you're going to do, what you want to be, or what your role in this life is going to be. Because trust me, not everyone is certain, and that's fine. Because we're only 17, 18, 19 years old, and you don't really need to know. Just don't forget to try things out and have fun, because this is the end of our beginning, and it's time to see what comes next for us. So thank you, class of 2020. Our time at West Carrollton High School is over, and it's time to let the class of 2021 take over, and for us to start our new lives as adults. I know that we're going to be great, and I hope to see you all again someday soon. So thank you so much for being an amazing class, and I'm going to miss you all very, very much. So goodbye, and thank you.
Hello, my name is Zeph Sutter. I'm the incoming class president of the class of 2021. First of all, I'd like to congratulate the class of 2020, those who are graduating this year. The circumstances under which you guys graduated were not ideal. However, you guys pushed through strongly and showed us as a whole school that Pirate Pride is real and that you can truly feel connected to your home school. Having a sister that is graduating this year really helped me to empathize with her and through her with all of you guys as a class. Throughout the year, whether we were actually present in school or not, I was able to see everything that you guys were accomplishing as a class and how close you guys were bonding. This isn't something that any class would be able to get through very easily, but you guys really toughed it out and it was very inspiring to me. Even after schools closed, you guys still managed to make the best of the rest of your guys' year. Now, class of 2021, the seniors helped us realize that we really do need to cherish the last year of high school. We don't know what next year holds for us, but whatever it is, I hope we're strong just like the class of 2020 and we're able to make the best of it. Saying that, I have no doubt that class of 2021 will be able to fill the shoes of class of 2020. Let's make sure we don't take this year for granted and that we do everything we can to remain positive. And with that, I want to congratulate the class of 2020 one more time and say good luck to whatever the next chapter in your life holds.
Everyone, I'm Brooklyn Kasher, student body president. I hope everyone is staying healthy and safe during this time. Unfortunately, this is not how we wanted to end our school year, but with this predicament, we have made it the best we could. Thank you to everyone for allowing me to represent you all this past year being student body president. It wasn't always easy, but it was definitely worth it. Freshmen, you have finally accomplished your first year of high school. It may have not ended the way you wanted, but do not get discouraged. You have 3 more years left. But although that seems like a lot of time, it sure does go by quick. Sophomores, you are halfway done. You will now be a part of upperclassmen, which means you need to take more responsibilities and lead your school. Your next year is going to be one of the toughest years of high school, but once you make it through, it will be worth it. Juniors, you guys are now the ones who everyone looks up to. You need to set good examples and cherish all the time you get. Don't miss out on a football or basketball or any sporting events. Make sure you go to dances and try to volunteer your time whenever you can. High school only happens once, so make the best of it. With that being said, I'm proud to hand over my role to Shundrick Parker, your new student body president. I know he'll take his job seriously and lead you guys the best way he knows how to. Good luck to everyone and thank you again.
Hi, good morning or afternoon. My name is Shundrick Parker and I'm the student body president for the 2020-21 school year. I hope everyone is doing well in this pandemic and doing the best they possibly can. I have never been amazing with large speeches, so bear with me. I just have a few things to say. First, to the class of 2023, I have seen you all grow from the new freshman to a valued part of this pirate family. Your journey has just begun, and I advise you to keep all the hard work you have put in and keep pushing forward and enjoy every second with your family and friends. To the class of 2022, you're now stepping into the zone of upperclassmen. From here on out, you will be seen as role models in sports, clubs, and the whole school. You may be asked to step up and take new responsibilities, but these should be opportunities you take and learn from. For some, you have cruised through high school with ease, but junior year challenges you in so many different ways, and I advise that you be prepared for this. Learn that sometimes you may fail, but there are seniors, teachers, and your family to help you through it all. Now the best class, 2021, my heart and soul. We are approaching being seniors. We are going to be the leaders of this school, and I think we got it down packed. All I have to say is, let's make it the best year we possibly can. It's our last year, and we're on our final countdown to the end, and let's enjoy it. We will win the Spirit Sword, the dodgeball tournament, and the Sassoon basketball game, and that's on, period. Finally, the stars of today, the class of 2020. You all are the last class besides my own that I started high school with, and you all have made me feel so accepted, and I will always appreciate that. We have made so many wonderful memories from football games to crazy homecomings and so much more. You have taught me so much and helped me in school and life. To my band and musical seniors, you have made me realize that anything I put my mind to, I can do. All I need is to practice. You all have so much ahead of you. Some of you are going to college, some to the workforce, and some even to the armed forces. And for that, we thank you for your service. No matter where any of you go, just know at West Carrollton High School, you are always welcome because you are a part of our pirate family. We are going to miss you all greatly, and good luck in the future. And to the whole student body and faculty, I hope you all are doing great and amazing. I would like to thank all the faculty and administration on behalf of the student body, for you all have been doing everything you possibly can to help us and ensure that our education continues. Thank you, and I hope you all are well right now.
So that concludes our virtual honors assembly. I hope you enjoyed it. I know it would have been much better in the auditorium, but this is the best we could do. I want to say thank you to all the teachers, administrators, counselors, secretaries, everyone at the high school that did a video. It was awesome how we came together just to try and do something to honor the seniors and everybody else that got an award. So I hope you enjoyed it. To the graduates, congratulations. We're so very proud of you. We wish you the best in whatever comes next in your life. And know we're always there for you if you ever need to come back for any advice or just to say, hey, let us know how things are going. And for the freshmen, sophomores, and juniors,
We hope to see your smiling faces in our classrooms in the fall. Nobody knows how it's going to look yet, but that's what we're hoping. But until then, just have a great summer. See ya.